is calculated on the basis of number of units produced multiplied with the wage rate. Okay, so that is how we did in straight piece rate system. Now coming to the Taylor's differential piece rate system, as we have seen, we can understand that there are two differential wages, right? Wage rate, differential wage rate. One is the higher wage rate and the second one is the lower wage rate. Here also, workers are identified on the basis of the piece rate, on the basis of the number of units produced. Okay, so a worker who is producing the standard expected units or beyond that will be awarded with a higher piece rate when computing the earnings. And a worker who has produced lower than the standard expected will be awarded with the lower piece rate. That's what we learned in Taylor's differential piece rate system. Now, in today's class, what we are going to look is, we are talking about the Merrick's multiple piece rate system. Merrick's multiple piece rate system. So as the name indicates, this system has multiple rates. If you closely look, it is just an extension of Taylor's differential piece rate system. Okay, Merrick's system is just an extension of Taylor's differential piece rate system, just to recognize the workers based on their production, based on number of units produced. So this is little more extended version of Taylor's piece rate system, differential piece rate system. Now let's look what it is. What you have to remember is, in this system, there are three wage rates applicable. In Taylor's, we had only two, right? Higher wage rate, lower wage rate. Here, there is a scale of three wage rate, which is to be remembered when you hear the word Merrick's multiple piece rate system. That's the main difference, the primary difference between Taylor's and Merrick's. And also in straight piece rate system, we were talking about only one piece rate. When it came to Taylor's differential piece rate system, we talked about two piece rate, that is the higher and the lower. All right. Now, when we are discussing about Merrick's, we are talking about three piece rate system, right? So this is something which you have to learn. This is standard, this is applicable, this is written in the theory part. So you have to by heart this by understanding that. So in Taylor and in Merrick's piece rate system, suppose if a worker is producing up to 83% of the standard expected units of production, he is provided with the normal piece rate. Suppose he is the standard being 100, if the standard is 100 units, if the worker is producing up to 83 units, okay, up to 83 units, he is provided with a normal piece rate. But if in case of Taylor, if the production was less than the standard expected production, the worker was given a low piece rate. But here, up to 83% of the standard production expected, standard units expected, the worker is paid the normal piece rate. Then, from 83% to 100%, okay, from 83% to 100%, the worker is paid with 110% of the normal piece rate. If it is up to 83, okay, up to 83, so it can be 82, 81, 80, 60, all that, the worker would be paid with normal piece rate. And if it is above 8, from 83% to 100%, 83 units to 100%, the worker will be paid with 110% of the normal piece rate. And above 100%, okay, above 100% means if he is producing above the expected standard units of production, the worker is paid with 120% of normal piece rate. That means this worker is very efficient. He is producing more than what is expected from him. So that is why he is paid 120% of the normal piece rate. So these are the three rates applicable in case of merits. One is if it is below the standard units produced, and if it is up to, no, up to 83%, maybe 82.49, 82.5, all these would be given with normal piece rate. And suppose if the worker is producing from 83 to 100%, 100 here in the cases, total standard production units expected. All right. So up to 100% of the standard units expected, then he is paid with 110% of the normal piece rate. And if the worker is very efficient, producing more than the standard units expected, he is given with 120% of the normal piece rate. So this is all about, it's very simple to remember once you understand straight piece rate system, Taylor's piece rate system, then this is just an extension of that. Right. So we said, in conclusion, we said in straight piece rate system, the workers are, the earnings of the workers are computed on the basis of number of units produced, right? And there is only one rate applicable to the entire workers within the factory. And we find that rate into number of units will give the earnings of the workers. Now, then we learned about Taylor's differential piece rate system, where we have two rates, the higher rate and the lower rate. A worker is producing the standard expected units of production or more than that will be given with the higher piece rate system, and a worker who is producing less than the standard will be given with the lower piece rate system. Then we discussed about the merits multiple piece rate system. We said that in case of merits, there are three rates which are applicable in the context of a factory or in the context of calculating the earnings for a worker. The first rate is if the worker is producing up to 83% of the standard production, the worker would be given with normal piece rate. If the worker is producing beyond 83 to 100% of the standard production, he would be given with 110% of the normal piece rate. And if he's very efficient worker producing more than the standard expected, the worker would be given with 120% of the normal piece rate. It's very simple. Now we will do exercise on this, right?